In this video, I will show you how to count the dates of the current month using two methods in Excel like this. So let's get started. Here in this Excel sheet, I have some dates in this column. Now I want to count the dates of the current month, which is April 2024. The first method to count the dates in the current month is by using the COUNTIFS function. To do that, I'm going to count all the dates that are greater than or equal to the first day of the current month and less than the first day of the next month. For example, the current month is April 2024. So I'm going to count all the dates greater than or equal to the 1st April 2024 and less than the 1st May 2024. We can use the EOMONTH function to get the first day of the current and next months. The EOMONTH function returns the last day of the month. This function takes two arguments, a valid date and a number of months. A positive value of the second number of months argument gives us a future date, and a negative value gives us the past date. For example, this EOMONTH formula will return the last day of the current month. This EOMONTH formula will return the last day of the next month, and this EOMONTH formula will return the last day of the previous month. Here is the formula to count the dates of the current month. The first condition checks if the dates are greater than or equal to the first day of the current month. Here, the EOMONTH function returns the last day of the previous month. I added 1 to it to get the first day of the current month. Similarly, the second condition checks if the dates are less than the first day of the next month. Here, the EOMONTH function returns the last day of the current month. I added 1 to it to get the first day of the next month. Overall, this formula means counting all the dates that are greater than or equal to the first day of the current month and less than the first day of the next month. As you can see, we now have the count of the dates of the current month. We can also use the sum product function to get the count of the dates of the current month. Here is the formula to do that. Here, in this part of the formula, I have combined the month and year numbers of all the dates in this column. Since there are 5 cells in the range, it returns an array of 5 elements containing month and year number strings for each cell. The elements are then compared against the current month and year number string, which is 42024, which is April 2024. The comparison returns an array of 5 elements containing true and false values. The true value is returned when the month and year string is equal to the current month and year string. The false value is returned when it is not. For the sum product function to work, we need to convert these true and false values to 1 and 0 respectively. We did that by applying the double negative minus minus. After applying the double negative, we get an array of 5 elements containing 1, 0, 1, 0, and 0. Finally, the sum product function sums up the array elements, and the result of that is 2. As you can see, we now have the count of the dates of the current month. Watch these videos to learn more Excel tips, tricks, and how-to tutorials. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel.